Amen. And I wasn't promised today, but I'm so glad that he gave it to me. How many glad God gave you today? Let's make it count, church. He gave us this day, so we're going to do the best of what we got with this day. Hallelujah. Amen. 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 So I'm thankful today that God has blessed me with a wonderful group of staff members on today. And even though one is going through, we're going to pray that he comes out. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. How many know that even the men when they're God need encouragement sometimes? So sometimes we do go through, but I just want to if there's three people in here, I just want you to hear this word real quick. The storm is passing over.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's all I'm going to say. I mean, it's passing.
Yeah.
Passing.
Oh,
passing. Listen, you'll catch that when you go home. But it's passing. She caught it already. It's passing.
Just me.
Look at somebody else and say, this word is a tailor-made word straight from Jesus. And it's going to fit me perfectly. I want to present the song and introduce us. None other than our very own Hermon Strong.
Good afternoon.
It's
good to see you all on today.
Man.
And Hermon done messed me up, y'all. And it's because
let him use you.
I wouldn't take anything for the Holy Ghost. It will come and see about those that you love.
Man.
And it just so happens, someone that I am so in love with is here to worship with me today, and it is my brother.
Amen. Pastor Lamont Maxson.
Notice I said he told me. He did not ask me. He told me. And I said, okay. So all week I have been in a mode of prayer and fasting just because of the state of the affairs of the world and in personal lives of people that I love and that I care a whole lot about. In a lot of cases, these are people that I would give my very life for.
Mm-hmm.
So I could not help them in the physical, but I could help them in the spirit.
Yeah.
So I have been in a place of fasting and prayer. And what the Lord gave me today when I asked him what my assignment was, and I've been asking all week, God, what is my assignment? What would you have me to say to your people? And what I am here to tell you my assignment today is to bring hope and encouragement. I am here to bring hope and encouragement to you on today. Hope and encouragement. And the scripture that I'm going to use, one of the scriptures I'm going to use today, comes from Psalm 24 and 7.
Right.
Say amen when you have it.
Amen.
It reads, lift up your heads, O ye gates, and be ye lift up, ye everlasting doors, and the King of glory shall come in. Who is this King of glory? The Lord strong and mighty, the Lord mighty in battle. Lift up your heads, O ye gates, even lift them up, ye everlasting doors, and the King of glory. Go going on, and then something happens. How many of y'all have had something to happen? Something happened. Let me tell you what happened.
What happened?
Something happened to make the people afraid.
Come on.
The messengers reported to King Jehoshaphat a large army from the countries of Moab, Ammon, and Mount Seir are coming to attack you, many Israelites. I'm going to say it again. The messenger had came to report to Jehoshaphat.
Yeah.
I'm going to tell y'all who y'all messengers are.
Okay.
The bill collector.
Yeah.
Your wayward children.
Yeah.
Your unfaithful spouse.
Yeah.
Your job that's giving you hell on every side.
Yeah.
Misunderstanding.
Yeah.
No, that's your messenger. That's what's coming to you.
Yeah.
That's what's making you afraid.
Uh-huh.
Mm, that's what's making you afraid.
Uh-huh.
I told you all when I taught on faith that the enemy's job has not changed.
Yeah.
It is simply still to kill, steal, and destroy you.
Yeah.
That's the messenger.
Right.
Whatever it is, it's coming to kill, steal, and destroy you.
Uh-huh.
And so the people had got afraid.
Uh-huh.
The people. The people had got afraid. The people. Mm-hmm. The people. They had got afraid. And so it said that he went on to seek Jehovah's help.
Yeah.
They go to the temple, and there Jehoshaphat prayed.
Yeah.
I said the people got scared.
Yeah.
Jehoshaphat prayed.
Yeah.
Hold on, get your paper and your pen, because you're going to take something down in a few minutes.
Yeah.
And Jehovah our God, we do not know what to do. We are helpless against this large army.
Yeah.
We look to you for your help. How many of y'all from the message you got felt helpless?
Come on, come on.
You were helpless because you didn't have that 3K that they was demanding in order for something to happen. You felt helpless.
Right.
Yeah. Maybe you had turned your electric and your gas off because you didn't have a Mountain Dew at all when you were in a position to make payment
around.
All right.
You
had
gotten scared.
All right.
Helpless.
Yeah.
And then had got shamed.
Yeah.
And didn't ask for no help.
All right.
But he to Jehovah. That's one of our biggest problems. We get angry with people because people don't help us when we think or how we think they should help us.
Uh-huh.
I want you all to clear that up for y'all stop falling out with people.
All
right. Yeah. Sometimes folks can't help you.
That's right.
In other cases, they don't desire to help you. Whatever it is, it's all good.
Yeah.
Because one of his names is Helper.
Come on. I be a member.
I hate seeing so many people so full of the world. I say full up. I ain't talking about y'all baby saints that just kind of getting in this thing. I'm talking full up.
All right.
As soon as a battle comes, they say, I don't know what I'm going to do, strong. And I become a little perturbed, to be quite honest with you. I'm being real honest. I become perturbed because as a seasoned saint, I know exactly what to do.
Yeah.
I know exactly what to do.
Yeah.
I'm going to go and talk to Jehovah and get some help.
Yeah.
That's what I'm going to do. So I got about 8 quick points that I want you all to get from the story of Jehoshaphat and about the battle not being yours and belonging to the Lord. One thing Jehoshaphat did was he sought God's help.
Yes.
After he sought, these are the things you're writing down. The first one, seek God's help.
Yeah.
The next one is pray to Jehovah. Know who to look to for help. Listen to the voice of God. Watch and see. Trust in Jehovah. Execute and expect while expecting. Then worship and praise Jehovah.
Yeah.
All right.
And as a result, I'm going to tell y'all, you know, I tell y'all a lot of time, I tell y'all a little bit of my business and then I'm going to get out of your way. I am not telling you anything that I have never done.
Right.
And I don't have a problem saying it, and my mother-in-law is sitting right next to my brother. So, you know, with the presidential debate going on, they have something called fact check. Mm-hmm. You can fact check if you like. I'll talk to my mother-in-law. I was living in Memphis with me and my two children and my husband. And we came to a place that marriage was not working for us. And everybody kind of, the few people that knew wondered what I was going to do, because most didn't know my husband had moved out. And I was still living in my own place at 4091 Druid Hill Drive, Memphis, Tennessee. 38128, I shall never forget. And I was going on about my business. My husband had been gone for some months though. But I was still getting up going about my business, taking my son to school and taking care of my 9-month-old daughter.
Talk.
His children, his seat.
Talk.
And on a Tuesday, when I had shortly gotten back from walking my son to school, because my husband had the car at the base that he was living on, there was a...
Come on.
I said, I don't know too many people over here. I don't know who would be knocking on my door. So I do what we do. I tipped to the door. I tipped to the door, y'all. And I looked at the people. And there was a brown man in a brown uniform. And he was from the sheriff's office. I said, I ain't getting to the sheriff. I'll be looking for me. I ain't getting nothing. And so I opened the door. And he said, are you Heather Straw? And I said, yes. He said, you've been served. I said, served for what? He said, for proceedings of divorce. You can because I and I cried and I grabbed my heart. But let me tell you all the real truth of the matter that no one had known other than God. I was in a place then in my life. I know y'all think I'm extra saved now, but no, back then I was real, 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 real saved. I really knew Jesus. I was a member of Bountiful Blessings of the G.E. Patterson. I knew the word frontwards and backwards. So I have to tell you all, after I stopped crying, I began to rejoice.
Well.
And let me tell you why I began to rejoice. Because God had did just what I asked him to.
Right.
The battle was not mine, but the Lord.
Right.
It was not that I wanted to continue to be married after all that I had been through, where you have cheated, made children, don't wear your wedding ring, don't come home, just live like you're a single man. Mm. I didn't want that for me.
Yes.
But I understood the covenant that I had made.
Yes.
So therefore, no matter what that man was doing, I was not going to ever petition the courts for divorce, and God knew that.
Yes.
Because of the word that I believe and the word that I knew. And my mother-in-law was real saved then too, see? Real extra saved too. So I was trusting God. And the thing about it was, Shonda, I wasn't trusting God to restore my marriage.
Yeah.
I was trusting God to provide a way of escape. He made that first move. And as soon as I got those papers, you can ask my mother-in-law. I called them. I said, I'm getting ready to get a U-Haul, and I'm on my way down 55. Her being who she is, who gonna help you? You got the kids. What you gonna do? I said, I'll see you in a little while.
Yeah.
I hung my phone up. I went upstairs, knocked on the neighbor's door, and said, I need to move. And I'm gonna get a U-Haul. Will you all help me pack it when I get back? And those were two women. There was no men. These were two women. They said, yes, we will. And I'll get my baby, I'll get my daughter to watch your baby while we pack. Because my daughter was only 9 months old. My son was six. I called a friend here in St. Louis who I've been friends with for years. I told you I was a housewife. I didn't have my money. He did. So I made a call. I need a U-Haul, and I need your credit card number.
Yeah.
I need you to call this number, and this is what I need you to do. That's what happened. Got my U-Haul, got my kids, and I came down 55.
Yeah.
And when I came down 55, I had my six-year-old son and my baby in her pumpkin seat. And I said, Chris, while I'm driving, because this was a six-shift truck I got, y'all. It was a six-shift because it was cheaper than the automatic. So I got it. I said, Chris, I need you to hold her bottle in her mouth while I drive. While she in her pumpkin seat. And we came on down 55 and came on from Dyersburg. And I made myself arrival back to St. Louis. Not knowing what I was going to do, where me and my babies were going to lay our heads. I knew nothing. But I did know that I had asked God to help. I did know that I had prayed for Jehovah. I did know that I was looking to the right place for help. Maneuvering and putting things in place. And yes, I was afraid.
Yeah.
What I want to tell you is sometimes you have to do it afraid.
Yeah.
Because God is not giving me the spirit of fear, but that of love and that of power and that of a sound mind. So keep moving. Even if you're afraid, Kim, keep moving.
Yeah.
And then as I was moving, I began to execute and expect God to answer on my behalf. And praise the God of my salvation. Yeah. And the reason that I put these words on the cross today and the churches out y'all can look at them is because most people, I know sometimes you lose battles out of default, and it's simply because you don't know what to do or say.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
And I'm really not a preacher, I am a teacher at heart. Uh-huh. And so I want to teach you what to say when you get in trouble.
Yeah.
In the back.
Yeah.
What you begin to say at home, Shonda, is the Lord God, my Father,
yeah,
the Redeemer, the Great I Am, yeah, the Prophet, the Shield,
yeah,
the Protector, yeah, the Creator, the Provider, the Prince of Peace, the Lord of Lords, the Way.
Counselor,
the mighty God, the everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. It's in the Word, y'all. So when you get in your next battle, if you don't know nowhere else to go, run Isaiah 9 and 6. And call on the Prince of Peace. Just call on the Prince of Peace. It's a baby here, and I will not call her name. But one day after service, she came up to me and she said, I just want to know, can you teach me how to pray like that? I don't know how to pray like that. And I've been just talking to God. And I told her, I said, she told me some of the stuff she had been saying. And I said, you got it. You said exactly what you're supposed to be saying. Because we try to make prayer so difficult for people. And it's not. It is simply opening up your mouth and declaring and decreeing what so you desire.
Right.
And whatsoever you desire that you declare and decree, you shall have.
Yes.
That's why I put these words up here so that you can know what to say. And another one that I told y'all when I first came here, I'm going to my seat. I told y'all one of my first exhortations here, I told you that thank you was the password.
Yeah. Yes, you did.
Let me tell you something. Sometimes your heart gets so overwhelmed, bro. Sometimes you get so overwhelmed that all you can say is, God, I thank you.
Yeah.
Because anything else you say gonna be wrong.
Yeah.
Anything else you say gonna bring you something you don't want to deal with.
Uh-huh.
My brother, I will not tell his business.
Yeah.
But right now he is faced with something that if God don't move and God don't be God, we in a jam.
Uh-huh.
And what I do know about God is, I've been long enough, Thurman, to know I once was young. But now I'm old. Because I'm hurting because he's hurting. Because I am an intercessor. I am touched by the infirmities of men. Because I take intercession for real, God. And so he had aggravated me throughout this process. And I can tell you, because I keep it 100 with him, though. He had aggravated me. Because his emotions was getting the best of him. And he started talking crazy. Crazy. When I tell you crazy, I'm going to give you one example of crazy that he told me, though. Well, if this just don't work out the way I need it to, I guess you're going to have to come visit me over on Delmar. Now, I'm stupid, y'all. I said, what's on Delmar? My crazy hospital. I told him exactly this. If that be where you end up over this situation for as much God as you know, shame on you.
Yeah.
Because you have the ability to speak a thing forth and to call that thing that is not as though it may be. You have the ability to open your mouth and declare and decree however you want it to be. Real place is victory is mine.